Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn the 12 steps that will take you from a beginner to mastering Google Analytics. By following these steps, you'll be collecting actionable data that you can use to stay ahead of your competition. You'll be a Google Analytics pro in no time. And even if you don't have time to apply all of these steps today, you'll find that even by applying a few of these steps, you'll have a more complete Google Analytics implementation that you can continue to improve. Let's jump in and cover the 12 steps to mastering Google Analytics. Step number one is to set up goals. Goals allow you to understand how your website and your marketing channels are performing. They let you report on important actions that people are taking on your website. For example, you can use goals to report on people completing forms like your contact form, subscription form, and other leads. Apart from tracking people viewing particular thank you pages on your website, you can also set up goals based on events, like watching videos and for particular levels of engagement. It's a good idea to track your primary and secondary objectives as goals. These are known as macro and micro conversions. Step number two is to tag all of your inbound marketing campaigns. Even if you can't tag all of your inbound marketing, by starting to use campaign tags, you'll begin to see what's working and not working. Campaign tags can be used to track everything from your email campaigns through to offline campaigns that direct people through to your website. Google provides a great tool to get started. It's called the URL Builder, and I've included a link in the description below this video. Step number three is to use Google Tag Manager. If you're not using Google Tag Manager already, it allows you to add the Google Analytics tag to your website. Then when you have additional requirements or extra things that you want to track, in most cases you can add tracking without having to change the code on your website. For example, if you wanted to track people watching YouTube videos embedded on your website, form submissions, or even people traveling between two different domains, you can do all of this and more with the help of Google Tag Manager. Step number four is to implement e-commerce tracking. This is of course important if you're selling online, as it means you can understand what's driving value, including the products people are purchasing, the value of your website content through to your marketing channels. You can even hack the e-commerce reports and use them to report on non-e-commerce websites, for example, to track internal website promotions. Step number five is making sure you have Google AdWords linked to Google Analytics. This ensures you're collecting accurate data from your AdWords campaigns. Plus, you can also pull some basic metrics like bounce rate from Google Analytics into your AdWords account. If you haven't already, make sure you link the products so you can understand how your paid campaigns engage your audience once they've clicked through to your website. Step number six is to look beyond the last click attribution model. Attribution is about how credit is given to your marketing channels when a conversion occurs. So by moving beyond the last click attribution model, you can get a better understanding of how your campaigns perform. I recommend the time decay model as a good starting point. You can find attribution related reports by navigating to conversions, then multi-channel funnels, and you'll find the model comparison tool under attribution. For even more on attribution, check out the resources in the description below this video. Step number seven is to configure and use the site search reports. These reports tell you what people are searching for on your website and can provide valuable insights for informing your content, navigation, and even your products and services. And if you don't have a search function on your website, then you might want to consider adding one. They can make it easier for people to find what they're looking for, and you'll receive the added bonus of being able to track what they're searching for. Step number eight is to apply segments to your reports. Applying segments allows you to view more granular details about your audience. For example, if your target audience is based in Vancouver, Canada, you can apply a segment to only view that portion of traffic. There are some great default segments which are built into Google Analytics. These include users who've converted, segments for organic and paid traffic, and more. Plus, you can also create your own custom segments to meet your own reporting and analysis needs. I recommend starting by creating and applying segments for your most valuable audience members. This will then allow you to understand how they're finding and engaging with your website. Step number nine is to understand important terminology. For example, knowing the difference between a user and a session, or exits and bounces. Understanding what you see in your reports is critical so you can take action based on your data. Since this video is about the steps to master Google Analytics, I won't drill down into lots of different terms, but again, you can find some great resources in the description below this video, including my Google Analytics glossary. Step number 10 is to link Google Search Console and Google Analytics. If you haven't already, then doing this lets you understand how your website performs in organic or free search results on Google. This means you can understand what people are searching for on Google to find your website and which pages are being shown in search results. You can use the reports to optimize your content to increase your traffic from Google. Step number 11 is to share your data. By giving more people in your organization access to information and insights, you're more likely to see improvements to your website, your marketing, and your conversions. Apart from giving people access to your Google Analytics reports, you can also create custom dashboards and reports inside Google Analytics. And you can even use Google Data Studio for more sophisticated reporting needs. If you haven't taken a moment to play with and learn about Google Data Studio, then I absolutely encourage you to check it out. It's an amazing platform for reporting and dashboards. You can even combine data from different sources, including Google Analytics, Google AdWords, YouTube, Google Sheets, and more. Step number 12 is to learn about the advanced features available in Google Analytics. There are new features and reports being added all the time, and it's important to stay up to date on all the latest developments. Just to be clear, I'm not saying you need to use every single feature or every single report. It's really about using what's going to help you achieve your objectives. By knowing what's available, you're in a better position to know if you should be implementing a feature or using a report for your organization. So they're the 12 steps to master Google Analytics. There are so many ways to use Google Analytics. Just remember, it's about finding and using the reports that help you achieve your objectives and drive improvement. Even spending a little time each week in Google Analytics can grow your knowledge and your skills. And you'll also be improving your website and your campaigns. Remember that you don't have to complete all of these steps today. Even using a single report or taking one of these steps can have an impact. So what's stopping you? It's time to log into Google Analytics, load up your reports, set up goals, and begin tracking improvements you're making to your website and your campaigns. You can and will succeed at mastering Google Analytics. Do you have any tips you'd like to add? Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.